Add the following integers. Add the following integers using number line. So here the questions are given as in. First question is 7 ± 6. And second question is -8 ± 2. Okay, just let us observe these two problems. What is the question? Add the following integers using number line. Without using the number line, also we can find out the values. That here they have mentioned by using the number line, we need to find out their sum. So use the number line, not a number line. See, if they have mentioned use vertical number line, then you have to use vertical only. If they have mentioned horizontal, in that case, we must use horizontal. But just here they said using number line. Means here we need, that is our wish. Instead of number line, we are using, that is our wish. So now observe here. First integer is 7. Means positive numbers we have to give. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And -1, -2. Okay, first integer was +7. So 0 to +7. And already yesterday we discussed, whenever we are adding a negative integer, we have to move left side. Is that not? So from 7 we have to move left side by 6 numbers. Okay. Otherwise plus into minus, minus. So because of minus we have to come back. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the answer is 1. 1 is plus, 1 is minus. So subtraction. 7 minus 6 is 1 and 7 is 7 plus 1, so plus 1. Let's observe. Okay. So don't confuse whenever you are having the first integer, first mark the first integer. Okay. After that, if you are adding the positive integer, you should move right side from that integer. If you are adding negative integer, in that case you have to come left side by that negative. Okay, so 7 plus 7, that's why 0 to 7. From here onwards, because we are adding negative integer, we have to come left side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 left side came, and we got 1 at the answer. That's all. Same thing do in the second problem also. So just see here, observe both are negative integers, like integers. In that case, we have to do the addition. So 8 plus 2 equal to 10. And both are having minus 10, so minus 10 will be the result. We will check with the number line. First integer minus 8. So negative side we want the values more. 0 plus 1 plus 2. Okay. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10. Now observe here, first integer is minus 8. So 0 to minus 8. Okay, again you are adding a negative integer. So negative integer means we have to come left side. Otherwise just observe, less into minus, minus. So because of minus we have to come left side. So where we have started at minus 8. Here onwards we have to move left side only by 2 steps. 1, 2. So what is the result? Minus 10. Okay. Now coming to the third problem. Minus 6. Plus a minus 5 plus a plus 2. Instead of 2 integers, here they are given 3 integers. No problem. They can add 2 or more than 2 integers. So now observe, draw the number line as usual. Because first number is minus 6, this left side will be minus 6 values compulsory. So 0, 1, 2, I am taking it right side. And minus 1, minus 2. Minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 11, minus 12, -30. I don't know which value I get. That's why I'm writing so many values. More than -6. Now observe, first value is -6. So as equal 0 to -6, we have to move. After that, between these two figures, we are adding a negative integer. So negative integer, whenever you are adding, it will come from left side. And by 5 steps. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. -10, -11, -12. Okay, so 6 plus 5 is 11. Both are negative, so -11. So we got -11. But till here, I am not finished because still we have plus of plus 2. Okay, that means we are adding a positive integer. Whenever you are adding a positive integer, you have to come right side. So plus into plus plus. Right side by 2 steps. System, wherever you have come. Till here I got -7. So from here I need to come right side by 2 steps. 1, 2. So what is the result? -9. Don't confuse. First, as usual, for first two integers, how we have done for this. And for third integer, where you got the answer, from there onwards you need to know. See, whenever you are adding the negative integer, you must come left side. If you are adding a positive integer, you have to move right side. Okay, so remember these points. Once again, observe the third problem. First integer was -6, so 0 to -6. After that, plus 2 minus minus. So, left side by right side, we have to move from -6. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we got -11. But till that answer now, we should still one more integer we need to add. That is plus 2. So, plus into plus plus. So whenever we are getting plus, we have to come right side, and there are two steps we need to move right side. So 1, 2, that is minus 9. Okay? Now coming to the remaining problems. answer is four problems. Minus 8 plus R minus 9 plus R plus 17. Okay, this is the fourth problem. We got three integers are there, so I am solving this one. Observe. Okay, first minus 8 I have, and again minus 10 on this. Means two negative integers. Compulsory we need to take more numbers to get the left side. So what I am doing? 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2. Minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10, minus 11, minus 21, minus 13, minus 14, minus 15, minus 16. Till here I have drawn. Now answer is, first integer is minus 8. So as I told you, 0 to minus 8 we need to move. And again, plus into minus minus. So, left side we need to combine 9 steps. From minus 8, 9 steps we have to move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, 9 steps. Till minus 7, we go. Now, till here, answer not finished. Because till plus 17 is there. So, plus into plus plus means right side we have to move by 17 steps. So what I'm doing? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So wherever I have started, there only I did. Plus 17 minus 17. Additive inverses. Sum of the two numbers is 0. 8 plus 9, 17. Because further I have minus. So minus 17. Minus 17 plus 17. Both we get here. Okay, so once again observe here, first integer is minus 8, so 3 minus 8 I have given. After that, plus into minus is minus, this we need to move left side by right side. So, further we are getting the answer minus 17. After that, we need to add plus 17. So, positive integer we are adding, we need to move right side by 17 steps. So, minus 17 plus 17 will be 0. Okay, and next is the problem. Minus 3 plus up minus 8 plus up minus 5. Okay, now observe this problem. Here all are negative values only. So negative side only will be given an answer. 0 plus 1. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So first integer we have minus 3. Okay, again minus 8. Negative side only will be minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10, minus 11, minus 12, minus 13, minus 14, minus 15, minus 16. Okay, now observe the problem. First integer is minus 3, so 0 to minus 3. First integer is over. Let's plus into minus minus. 8 is there. Okay. So 8 steps we have to come left side. Because plus into minus minus. Whenever we are going to minus left side, we have to come. So left side by 8 steps. Come minus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So till minus 7 we got. Still one more integer we have, that is minus 5. Again, negative integer we are adding, so we need to come left side. Plus into minus minus. 5 steps. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what is the result? Minus 16. Okay. Till here we have performed minus 8. This is minus 3, minus 8, and again minus 5. We are getting the final result minus 16. Do you have any doubt? The steps of all are like integers. Yes, we need to go for addition. 3 plus 8, 11, 11 plus 5, 16. Because all are having minus 10, so minus 16. So our answer also minus 16. Okay? Now coming to the last problem. Minus 1 plus 7 plus minus 3 is equal to. So just observe it into drawing number and number 3. First value is minus 1. So what I am doing? 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Now observe the question. Here minus 1. For this 7, they did not give any bracket. Either it is plus 7 or minus 7, they did not give. But just I already told you for a positive integer, no need to keep plus 7 also. Means 7 is a positive integer. Okay. So minus 1, minus 3 are negative. Minus 1, minus 3 both are like. So 1 plus 3 equal to 4 minus 2. Minus 4 and plus 7 are unlike. So 7 minus 4 equal to 3 means we will get plus 3 as the answer. We will look by the number like. See, first integer is minus 1. So 0 to minus 1. Okay. And we have plus 7. So positive integer we are adding 7. Okay. Plus 7 means right side by 7 sets we have to know. So that's what 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Till here I got up. But still I need to add minus 3 to the result. So I got minus 3 at the result. Now from minus 3 I am adding negative number. Plus into minus minus. So left side I have to combine 3 steps. That is 1, 2, 3. So what is the final result? Minus, plus 3. So first the next step, minus 1. And from this we got plus 7. And after that again we got minus 3. So final result is 3. Okay. So remember first integer is minus 1. So 0 to minus 1 again. Plus 7 means right side we have to come by 7 steps. So then we got 6 as the result. And after that, minus 3 is there. So, whenever we are adding negative integer, we have to come left side. By 3 steps. So, we are getting minus plus 3 as the result. Okay? So, this is the last problem from the first question. And remaining problems without using the number line, we have to do. And the first problem is 10 plus or minus 3. And second question is minus 10 plus or plus 16. And the third problem is -8 + 7 + 8. And fourth problem is -250 + 7 + 100. And fifth question is -110 + -120. And sixth problem is 17 + 7 - 7. So just observe the given question. Each and every problem only two integers given. So we had already addition table. Whenever two unlike integers are there, in that case we need to go for subtraction and we must keep greater than sign. If we are having like integers, in that case we must do the addition and whatever sign they are having, that symbol we must do. So now observe this. 10 is a positive integer. So first thing you need to identify which type of integers are given and which operation is there to be. So between 10 and 90 we are having plus operation. Means we need to add those two integers and one is positive, one is negative. Unlike integers. So in case of unlike integers we have to do the subtraction. So 10 minus 3 is 7 and we must keep greater number 7. Here 10 is nothing but plus 7. So, n only greater number. That's why you get the result as plus 7. Single step will get the answer. Okay, same like the problem, we will do for the remaining. Observe, one is minus, one is plus. So, unlike. And here 16 is greater, 16 is having plus, means our result also plus only. 16 minus 10, plus 6. I hope you understood. So, once again, observe. Whenever two unlike integers are there, observe these two cases. In these two cases, both are unlike integers only. One is positive, one is negative. So, whenever we are getting unlike integers, we have to subtract and we must keep greater number 7. So, 10 minus 3 is 7, 10 is having plus 7, so plus 7. And here, minus 10 plus 16, both are unlike integers. So, 16 minus 10 is equal to 6. And 16 is having plus 7, so plus 6. And now, -8 + 8. Observe this. Both are additive inverses. 8 minus 8 is 0. One is positive, one is negative. 8 minus 8 is 0. And 0 is neither positive nor negative. Okay? And sum of the additive inverses are always 0. So these two are additive inverses. Okay? Yesterday only we have discussed about this. And coming to the next, that is minus 1 is plus. Again, subtraction. So here greater number is 215. 215 minus 100, that is 115. Because 215 is having minus sign, so minus 115 we must do. That's all. And coming to the fifth problem, observe -110, -22. Both are like integers. So we have to do the addition. 110 plus 22. How much will you get? 132. Because both are having negative sign, so we must keep negative symbol. Okay? And here again positive, negative, subtraction. So 17 minus 11 is 6. And because 17 is having plus sign, so we can write plus sign as simply 6, no problem. So remember, whenever you are getting unlike integers, go for subtraction and put the greater number 7. See, except this problem, remaining all are the unlike integers only. And here, this third problem, sum of the additive inverses is always 0. And whenever you are getting like integers, means either both are positive or negative, in that case, we must go for addition and we have to keep the minus 7. Whatever sign they are having. Here, in these two questions, they are negative integers, so the result also negative. If both are positive, result is positive. And now coming to the next speaker. Find the sum of first problem 120 and -274, and secondly -68 and 28. Third question is -29, 38, and 196. And fourth question is -60, -100, and 300. Okay, these are the given four problems. Now observe here, find the sum. Sum is nothing but addition of two. Yes or no? So find out the sum of these two numbers. So, which one we need? Sum is equal to, required sum is equal to 120 + -274. Whenever you are getting a negative number, compulsory use the brackets. So -74. Now for positive integers, we need to keep brackets. 120 is a positive number, -274 is a negative number. One is positive, one is negative. So unlike integers, what we have to do? Subtraction. Subtraction in the sense 274 - 120. So that is what you will get. 4 - 0 = 4, 7 - 2 = 5, 2 - 1 = 1. And because bigger number is having minus 10, so -154 is the result. Okay? Same, coming to the second question. Here are the only two integers are, right? Very simple. Required sum is equal to -68 + 28 actually. So one is plus, one is minus. Again subtraction. 68 - 28 = 40. And 68 is more than 28, that's why -1. Okay? Coming to the third question. Required sum is equal to -29 + 38 + 190. See, because these two are positive numbers, I am not at all writing brackets. Now remember, here more than two integers we are getting. So whenever more than two integers are getting, first you will get addition operation, after that subtraction. How does it observe? Identify the like and unlike integers. So -29 is negative, remaining 38 and 190 are positive. Since these two are like integers. So for those two like integers, find the sum first. That means -29 keep like the number. Okay. Find out the sum of these two integers. So 190 + 38 is nothing but 8. 9 + 3 = 228. Okay. And one is positive, one is negative. That's what I told you. First we will do the addition for like integers. After that, compulsory we get the unlike integers. Certain numbers in unlike integers, then we have to do the subtraction. So 228 - 29, that is -1. 228 is greater number and it is having less than, so plus 199. 8 is less, so 18 - 9 is 9, and 1 will be there, so 11 - 2 is 9, and 199. Okay? Same this one also, like the only we must do. -60 + -100 + 300. So whenever you are getting more than two integers, compulsory you will get two after operations. So if you are getting all are like, then single script will get the answer. But when some are positive, some are negative, in that case first we will regroup the like integers and we will find out this one. After that we will find the unlike integers. So now observe it. -60 and -100 are both are negative. 300 is positive. So first of all, find out the sum of negative numbers like integers. 60 plus 100 is 160. Both are having minus 10, so minus 160. Plus 300. Now finally, one is positive, one is negative. So unlike integers, we have to go for subtraction. 300 is greater number and it is having plus 10, so our result also plus only. 300 minus 160 will be 140. Plus 140. Okay. So observe, if you are getting only two integers, either addition or subtraction, you will do. If both are unlike, then we will do subtraction and we will give the greater number sum. If more than two integers are given, in that case, first identify the like integers, find out their sum. After that, go for subtraction because final result you will get unlike integers. So observe this. Here 38 and 190 are like integers. So we have counted their sum. 228 we got. And 190 is positive. So that's why we are doing the subtraction and we are keeping the greater number sum. And second problem, 30 plus or minus 30 plus or minus 60 plus or minus 80 is equal. Okay, answer the first question answer. Simplification is nothing but adding value to find out either sum or subtraction or whatever. So just observe here, because in every integer, if in every integer we are having plus, plus, plus. Total four integers are there. Okay, as I told you, first we get the addition after the subtraction. See, between every integer we are adding addition operation. It means we need to find out sum of these four integers. Okay, and so that first we group the like integers. So already they are in group total. See, minus 6 is negative, minus 10 is negative, both are negative. And 5 and 17 are positive, both are negative, they are negative. So write in the brackets, minus 6 plus or minus 10. Means we need to find out this sum first. Brackets, use of brackets are to plus or 5 plus 17 are positive. Like integers we have grouped. So now find out the sum of the like integers. That is minus 6 minus 1 both are like. So 10 plus 6 is 16. both are having minus 9, so minus 16. Plus up, 17 plus 5, 22. Plus 22 on 2. That's why I am not writing that. Now, which is equal to positive, negative. That's what I told you. Whenever you are getting more than 4 two integers, first you will get addition operation, after that subtraction. So 22 minus 16 is 6, and 22 is greater number, so plus 6 will be the result. Okay, now coming to the second problem. Here, before doing that, what I told you, first we do the negative integers. So, except that the remaining all are negative integers. Okay, means we need to find out these three sums. After that, we have to go for subtracting 30 from the result. Just observe this plus 30 and minus 30. Both are additive inverses. Yes or no? Sum of additive inverses is always 0. So, for that sake, what I am doing, instead of adding all like integers, I am regrouping like that. 30 plus of minus 30 plus minus 60 plus of minus 18. Remaining two integers. Because these two are additive inverses, that is the reason. Otherwise, I need to regroup like that only, whatever I will have discussed. So, here observe, plus 30 minus 30 will get the answer because the sum of two additive inverses is 0 and both are negative integers. So, we have to add those two integers. 16 plus 18 is 78. So, because of minus 78 and 0, if you are adding 0 to any integer, you will get same number. Why? Because it is an additive identity. So we will get minus 78 as the result. Okay? So if you want to do like this only, add these three integers, finally you need to subtract 30 from the result. Then also you get minus 78. So just observe it. 30 plus 16 is 19. 19 plus 18 is 108. Minus 108 plus 30. Positive, negative. Negative, positive. So subtraction. 108 minus 30. So 100 minus 30 is 70. 78 because minus 0 to minus 30. Same is 70. Okay? Now coming to the remaining two problems. Okay, here the problem is minus 80 plus up plus 40 plus up minus 30 plus up plus 6. And last problem is 70 plus up minus 80 plus up minus 10 plus up minus 70. Okay, observe these two questions again. So here, what are the negative integers? Are there all those negative integers grouped together and positive integers also? So observe the given integer. Every integer we have plus, plus, plus only. And that means we need to find out the sum of these four integers. As well as, minus 80 is negative, 40 is positive, minus 30 is negative, minus 6 is negative integers. So three integers are negative. Okay, group them. What is it? Minus 80 plus up, minus 30 plus up, minus 6. And here last integer is plus 1. Only one positive integer we have. So find out the sum of the negative integers. That is 80 plus 30, 110. 110 plus 6, 116. Both are all are having negative signs, so minus 160 plus up plus 40. So just observe one is negative, one is positive. Unlike integers, what we have to do? Subtraction. So 160 minus 40. 6, 7 minus 4 is 7. That's 76. So here because minus 116 is having. Minus 116 is greater than 40 and it is having minus 9, so we will get minus 76 as the result. Once again observe, here three like integers we have, all those are negative, so find out their sum. After getting that, go for subtraction because the resulting are unlike integers. So find out the difference between those two numbers, so we got 76 their difference. And because greater number is having minus 9, so we got minus 76. Now same thing here also we need to apply. Again here also we are having three negative integers and all those are already they have been considered only. So 70 plus half minus 80 plus minus 10 plus the minus 17. These three are negative, so add the three integers. 70 plus half. What we get? 80 plus 10, 28. 28 plus 10, 38 plus 7 is 45. Because of minus, so minus we have to take. Okay. So now 70 is positive number and 45 is negative. So unlike subtraction, 70 minus 45 we have to do, that is 25. And because 70 is more than 45, 70 is less than, so plus 25 we have to do. That's all. Okay, so this is about how to add the integers whenever two integers are given and when more than two integers are given. And next, how to add by using the number line we have studied now. So still some more extra problems we will do. We will do on this topic only in the next class. here some questions that I gave you with the same topic. Okay, answer is finally sum up. -373 -20, -3, -5 and 5. So like they are given the questions. In this case, just observe the given integers. They are asking to find out sum of them. So what is the required sum right now? Sum is equal to -373. The negative number, so I am writing in bracket +20 because it is positive. I am not writing brackets. +3 -5 +5. So observe the given integers. Here total 5 integers are given. So we need to regroup the like integers. That means -373 is negative. -3 is negative. -5 is negative. Remaining 2 are positive. So write the negative integers together: -373 +3 -5. Otherwise, observe one thing: +5 -5 is both will get cancelled. Yes, because sum of all the integers is 0. Okay, and +20 +5 are positive integers, 2 positive integers. So which will be equal to, add all these numbers: 373 + 3 = 376. 376 + 5 = 388 and 11 -3 = 11 -3 = 11 is the result +25 is +12 -3 -5 = 5 and 356. So this will be the result. So remember, whatever products they are given, first rearrange the given values and add the like integers, and after that find out the difference to get the result. Okay. Still depending on this topic, we will discuss some more problems in the next class.